Hey, Psych2Goers, welcome back to another video. Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, or ADHD, is a disorder marked by an ongoing pattern of inattention or hyperactivity that interferes with functioning and development. It can make focusing on everyday tasks and routine challenging. ADHD doesn't mean that you cannot focus. In some cases, it means that you focus intensely on something that may not be a priority. Some people describe it as a constant feeling of being overwhelmed or paranoid. For years, people with ADHD were stigmatized and labeled as lazy, procrastinators, flaky, or irresponsible. These labels only produce shame and prevent those with ADHD from seeking help. But please remember that these labels do not represent who you are. Before we begin, remember that this video is for educational purposes only and is not intended to be a substitute for professional advice, diagnosis, or treatment. With that said, here are five signs you might have ADHD. Number one, childhood history. It's common for people diagnosed with ADHD as adults to have exhibited symptoms during childhood, even if they were not formally diagnosed. A reason you may not have been diagnosed is that ADHD shares similar symptoms with depression, mood swings, forgetfulness, and an inability to focus. Number two, short attention span. Speaking of similarities between ADHD and depression, the most common similarity is short attention span. However, the difference between them is motivation. Someone with ADHD has a short attention span as a result of the condition. There is no definitive reason to explain why a short attention span is one of the symptoms. However, researchers believe that differences in brain structure might play a role. It's not that you're incapable of being focused, it's that something else caught your brain's attention. ADHD can also make you hyper-focused on something. It sounds paradoxical, but this too is seen as having a short attention span. Or to restate, a selective attention span. Number three, leaving things unfinished. As a result of a short attention span, you might be prone to leaving things undone. Projects, housework, homework might be put off for another day or fall to the sidelines, regardless of how enthusiastic you are to start them. Though frustrating and incredibly challenging, there are therapies that can help. Doctors typically prescribe medication as a form of treatment. Depending on your ADHD, they may prescribe stimulants or non-stimulants to help you focus. There is also the option of psychotherapy, where a therapist might engage in behavioral therapy or cognitive behavioral therapy. Number four, poor impulse control. Another sign that you might have ADHD is poor impulse control. Now, this wouldn't be a one-off clothing splurge. This is more like doing something you know you should not do, like running a red light or maxing out your card on something you know you don't need. You may not even know why you do things, you just do them. That's what poor impulse control is. It's acting without any foresight. But impulse control is not always as dramatic. Sometimes it can be as subtle as having distractions for your distractions, interrupting conversations, engaging in risky behaviors, or spending large amounts of money when your bank account is low. Number five, inability to get organized. The last sign that you might have ADHD is that you cannot seem to get organized. Deadlines creep up out of the blue and priorities have gone out the window. But do not fret, there is hope. While calendars, planners, and bullet journals may work for some, they may not work in your case. However, alarms may help. Give yourself 30 minutes to an hour to complete something from your to-do list. After the alarm rings, move on to the next item, whether you finish the previous item or not. That way, you don't get stuck working on one thing. So, did you relate to any of these signs? I did. We hope you've learned about some of the different signs of ADHD. Consult a mental health professional if you identify with these signs. They can guide you through forms of therapy that can be greatly beneficial. Please like and share it with friends that might find some insight in this video too. Make sure to subscribe to Psych2Go and hit the notification bell for more content. All the references used are added in the description box below. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.